गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑन द न्यू टॉपिक ट्रांसपोर्टेशन। स्टूडेंट्स, एज द टर्म ट्रांसपोर्टेशन मीन्स द ट्रांसफर ऑफ एनी सब्सटेंसेस फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर, दैट इज कॉल्ड ट्रांसपोर्टेशन। But in the sense of a human body, its role and its function will be different. It is just not the process of transportation like the movement of any body or any substances from one place to another. It is a in human beings, it is a biochemical process as well as you can also told it. It is a process of physiology. Now let us talk about the transportation in human beings according to our syllabus. Transportation in human beings. Transportation in human beings. Right, students? Now, how we can define the transportation in human being? It may be defined as the movement of food materials, gases like oxygen and carbon dioxide, as well as nitrogenous waste such as urine, uric acid, like many more, from one place to certain or specific part of the body with the help of a group of organs that is called circulatory system. That is called circulatory system. The process of transportation in human beings is carried by a particular group of organs that is called circulatory system. Now let us talk about circulatory system. What is circulation and what is circulatory system? Circulatory system, right? Circulation or circulatory system. Students, here I want to know about the importance of William Harvey. William Harvey was the biologist who firstly confirmed about the blood in the human body not stagnant, it continuously flow into the blood vessels with the help of a pumping organ that is called heart. Heart is our natural pumping organ that not only intake the blood from the whole body parts but also pump out that blood to the whole parts of the body. Thus, the circulatory system of human beings is composed of blood, blood vessels and a natural pump set of our body that is heart. Students, we classify the parts of the circulatory system by the following flowchart, that is circulatory system, right students? Now here I draw the flowchart of the circulatory system on which we have to study. You all of you study in earlier classes, or you can say that previous classes in class 9 on the topic tissue, the vascular tissue, about the blood and blood vessels. But I want to explain once again so that the topic of transportation or transportation in human beings can be clarified more sense. Then the vascular fluid, here I take the three important parts of the circulatory system, the vascular fluid of the body. Next, the blood vessels, and the most unique part of this circulatory system, that is heart. Okay, there are two types of vascular fluids present in our body. What are they? The first one is blood vascular system or blood, and another is lymphatic system, that is lymph. Now students, the blood is also composed of two main components. The first one is plasma or blood plasma, and the another is capsules or blood cells or capsules. Now students, there are three types of blood capsules found in the human body. What are they? The first is RBCs, red blood capsules or red blood cells. You can abbreviate as or pronunciate as RBCs and red blood capsules or cells. And the another is WBCs, white blood capsules or white blood cells. And the third types of the blood cell is platelets. The third type of blood is blood platelets or platelets. The students, it is also known as, the RBCs are also known as erythrocytes. WBCs are also known as leukocytes, and the platelets are known as thrombocytes. That are the biological names of these blood capsules or blood cells. Now students, the WBCs, on the basis of safe of nucleus, is also classified into two categories. What are these? Look at here. The first one is granulocytes, and the second one is agranulocytes. Okay, students, granulocytes and agranulocytes. As their name confirms, granulo, that is taken from the word granules. It means very minute particles like structures. That is granules. Granulocytes, the kind of blood cells or blood corpuscles that contains many small particles, same structure in their plasma, that are called granulocytes, whereas those which do not contain such kind of structure in their cytoplasm or plasma, that are called agranulocytes. The students, the granulocytes are further classified into three parts on the basis of shape of nucleus. What are they? They are eosinophils, if the number of this WBC increases, the person is suffering from severe cold like symptoms, that is called scrofuria. The second one is basophils. And the third one is neutrophils. As I told the students, these classification is based on the type of nucleus found in such kinds of WBCs. Likewise, agranulocytes are also two types. What are they? They are lymphocytes and the next one is monocyte. Lymphocytes are lymphocyte and monocyte. This type of WBC, it means a granulocytes of WBC, are very helpful to provide and maintain the body immunity. That's why these both type of cells are associated with our body immunity. They act as a soldier and also helps to provide and prevents the infectious diseases which are caused by the microorganism like bacteria, viruses, fungi and others. Now students, we are talking and describing about the second part of the circulatory system, blood vessels. There are three types of blood vessels are also found, in which the blood, the vascular connective tissue blood flow easily and comfortably. The first one is artery. Its plural is arteries. arteries, that is a plural of artery, veins, singular is vein, and capillaries, its singular is capillary. Students, arteries are an artery. An artery is thick walled blood vessels that always carries oxygenated blood from the heart to whole parts of our body. Now we are talking about veins. Veins are comparatively thin walled blood vessels, but they always carry deoxygenated blood from the whole body towards our heart. Thus, artery and veins are antagonistic on the basis of function to each other. It always carries oxygenated blood from our heart to whole parts of body, and the deoxygenated blood from the whole parts of body to the heart is carried by the veins. That's why functionally both are antagonists. One thing is more noticeable, that the artery that arises from the heart towards the lungs, that is called pulmonary artery. Students, the pulmonary artery always carries deoxygenated blood. That is the exception. All kinds of arteries always carry the oxygenated blood, but the pulmonary artery always carries deoxygenated blood. Always carries deoxygenated blood. Is that clear? The pulmonary artery always carries deoxygenated blood. Students, I hope you will understand what is oxygenated and what is deoxygenated blood. But I want to explain the oxygenated and deoxygenated. Oxygenated blood, the blood in which rich amount of oxygen is present, is known as oxygenated blood. In very clear sense, such types of blood contain more amount of oxygen. The hemoglobin protein of the red blood cells easily bind with the abundant amount of oxygen. Such types of blood tissues are said to be oxygenated blood tissues that helps in carrying oxygen to the various part of our body cells with the help of blood for the process of respiration and other metabolic activities. Likewise, deoxygenated, the kind of blood that contain less amount of oxygen, or you can say that more amount of carbon dioxide, that is called deoxygenated blood. Like the pulmonary artery, here we also discuss about the pulmonary vein. Okay, students, pulmonary vein. The term pulmonary is common in both, but change their characteristics. In veins, I was explained that the veins always carry deoxygenated from the whole parts of body to our heart. But The pulmonary veins are the kind of blood vessels in which always flow oxygenated blood. Always flow oxygenated blood. Students, in the previous topic, we are studying about the respiratory tract or respiratory system of human. There I was mentioned. Our lungs is also known as pulmon. Due to presence of large number of alveoles, the distal pulmonary is taken from the lungs. It means these are the connecting blood vessels between the heart and our lungs. That's why the pulmonary term is taken here, and this term changes the behavior of these vessels. The veins are known for the transportation of deoxygenated, but the pulmonary vein always carries oxygenated blood from the heart to the four parts of our body. Okay, students. Now, if artery and veins both are antagonistic in function and complete the process of circulation, then what is the role of capillaries? Students, capillaries are just like the bridge that connects the end to end of a road, a way, just like the capillaries. Capillaries are the very thinnest blood vessels that transport the important food materials as well as waste material in such type of organs, tissues, where the arteries and veins are absent. In such part of our internal organs, the capillaries carry such kind of essential substances as well as the waste matter from these organs. Thus, the capillaries, you can say that, perform the function of both, the function of artery and the function of capillaries, and they are found in the internal delicate organs in the deep maxillary regions, or maintain the process of transportation, or you can say that circulation in such types of cells, tissue, organs, and organ systems. Thus, students, the third part of the circulatory system is heart. Moreover, heart, we are discussing. In our next lecture, keep watching to know more about heart and this part of the circulatory system in our next lecture. Thanks, students, for joining today's lecture.